Settle back, friends, take a sip or two. I got a little recipe I'd like to share with you. It's been handed down for years on South Bass Island. It's tasty, it's delectable, it's really a fine one. You make it in the early part of summertime from the freshest ingredients that you can find. It's not deep fried perch or walleye barbecue. It's genuine Put'n Bay Mayfly stew. Mayfly stew, Mayfly stew. Pour me out another bowl or two. It's nutritious and delicious and it looks like glue. It's genuine Put'n Bay Mayfly stew. Start with some mayflies, I'd say about a million. Put them in a fridge so they can all start chilling. Soak them in water with just a little bit of salt, a big bam of essence and just a pinch of malt. Then you chop up some garlic, about 150 cloves. Some onions, some celery, maybe a couple of tomatoes. To complete your preparation, you'll need to make a stock. So go snag a carp from the public docks. Ah, put it in a pot, cover him with water. Bring it to a boil, and I tell you, you nearly got her. Let her simmer on down, pour it up here. Then strain the liquid out until you got it nice and clear. Mayfly stew, mayfly stew. Pour me out another bowl or two. It's nutritious and delicious and it looks like glue. It's genuine Put'n Bay Mayfly stew. I should probably mention here the best way to catch them is you go down to the lake shore when they all start hatching. Wear a white shirt, take along a flashlight, and you should get your quota by the end of the night. If you're not a gourmet then, buddy, you should go to D. Riviera Park when the sun gets kind of low. Take along a shovel, take along a fishing net, and you can get what you need without any sweat. Make sure you catch the young ones. Don't take no oldies. They should have a tinge of green and not be brown or moldy. Their wings should be folded up and not in a bunch. And their abdomens should pop with a satisfying crunch. Mayfly stew, mayfly stew. Pour me out another bowl or two. It's nutritious and delicious and looks like glue. It's genuine Put'n Bay Mayfly stew. Take the mayflies from the fridge and put them in a blender. Then push the puree button and let it spin till you render every little carcass into a uniform mass. And then get a spoon and take a little taste test. Add some cayenne and your preferential spice. I find it parsley, sage, rosemary, and thyme work nice. And then mix it with the stock and reduce it till it thickens. Be sure to cook it slow and then stir it like the dickens. It'll start to smell so good and it'll put you in a coma. Your friends and the police will stop to check out the aroma. So ladle them up a big dish, have a celebration. Put live ones on top, that's your presentation. Mayfly stew, mayfly stew. Pour me out another bowl or two. It's nutritious and delicious and it looks like glue. It's genuine Put'n Bay Mayfly stew.